Hello everyone. In this very video, I'm going to tell you how to write notice. Usually, notice comes in the writing skill section, and that is section B of question paper. Notice writing is a part of short composition. To understand a notice, we have to first see what we write in that, why we write. So a brief introduction to notice writing. A notice is a written or printed information or news announcement. The purpose of notice is to disseminate, that is spread widely, information related to different issues or occasions. What kind of occasions we are talking about that are informed through a notice? Here we have an event, that is either a competition or an exhibition or an inauguration that is about to take place in near future. Or we can talk about any other school activity, maybe a visit to a certain place or an excursion or a picnic or a selection of participants for any activity. At the same time, it can be about collection of creative writings and work for school magazine, or collection of donation like books or clothes or through funds collection for donation purpose, group photographs, or a lecture of some eminent writer, leader, or scientist who is visiting the school. Now we have to remember that usually a notice is displayed at prominent places in the school, on display boards, or it is published in newspapers or magazines. The tone and style of a notice is always formal and it is factual. The language is simple but formal, and content is brief. It is always to the point. No extra. That's why it is considered as a formal skill. Now, this very exercise, notice writing, it is of maximum 4 marks. These 4 marks are distributed in the manner. Format is given 1 mark, and in the format, we include organization's name, that is issuing agency, the word notice, heading, that what is the purpose of writing this notice, depending on the event, activity, or any other occasion. Then date, the date is the issuing date, the release date, when we want the information to be passed on to others. And towards the conclusion, we have the signatory authority, that is the writer of the notice, his name along with his signatures and his designation. All these points, they are a part of format and it is of 1 mark. The content is of 2 marks, and in this content, usually the most relevant information is provided, and questions like what, when, where, why, how, whom, they are answered. And last remaining 1 mark is devoted to expression. By expression, it is meant that the fluency or the organization of ideas, whether it is appealing, whether the information provided in the content, it is relevant to the question asked, and spellings as well as grammar. You have to remember the word limit for a notice writing is 50 words, and the entire notice is written in a box. So after you have written the content, you have to draw an outline, making a box and concluding your notice. Now have a look at the format. If you have a look at the top line, you will see that here we have got name of the institution. This is the name of the institution, that is the issuing agency. After that, we come across word notice. Word is to be written. We are not talking about anything else. In this date, the third line is having date. It is to be written on the left hand side, But this word date is not to be written. You have to just write down the date, not the word date. Date is written in two manners. Either we write down the date first and then the month name and the year. Or we write down month name first, then the day, and then comma, and after that the year. You have to remember, next comes heading. If you have a look, I have written the heading in capital letters. The purpose is simply that the heading must be highlighted. You can write it down in a running handwriting and underline it. After writing the heading, it is your choice whether you want to leave a line or not. If you leave a line, it looks really good. Reason being that heading is highlighted. After that, we come across the content. If you have a look, in content, we are talking about all the relevant information. So, required information means as per the question, whatever information is required. And in this, what we do? We answer WH questions. By WH, we mean what? What is the purpose of writing? When it is going to take place, the event we are talking about, where it will take place, it means we have to tell the venue, why this particular event is going to be held. Like if we are talking about the collection of articles, poems, we have to tell because we are collecting it for school magazine. If we are talking about collection of funds, what is the purpose of those funds? Are we going to donate it? If yes, then how we are going to donate and to who we are going to donate. And at the same time, many a times we need to mention some other person to whom a person in question can contact if he has any kind of a doubt. So that comes here as who. In the conclusion, we have the signature. Signatures are of the signatory authority, the person who is the writer of this notice. After his signature, we write down his name and also provide his designation. Before we move on to some example of the notice writing, a quick recap on the important points. You have to remember that the word limit is 50. And make it a point to sticking to that very word limit. Second, give an appropriate heading. It should not be a sentence, but yes, it should give one reader the particular idea what the topic is about. Do mention date, venue, and time of the event in the content and provide all necessary information. That is, all WH type questions are answered. Mention whom to contact if there are further questions. Either it is going to be contact undersigned. Remember here, when we mention undersigned, you have to make it ED there. This is the common error students make. They just write down undersigned. But the word is undersigned, okay? And any other person, but along with that very person, you will have to mention his designation also. Suppose you say Miss XYZ, but who is this Miss XYZ? You are going to talk about she is a teacher or she is in charge or she is heading this event that you have to provide. In conclusion, you have to provide the name as well as the designation of the writer. And after writing all this, please put your notice in a box. Now here we have one example. The question says, write a notice informing the students and visitors not to park their scooters, bicycles, motorbikes in front of the school gate. You are the head boy of HRM Public School, Ram Colony, Delhi. Now, if you have a look at it, you will find the notice is for students and visitors about what? Not to park their scooters or vehicles. And who is the writer? The writer is head boy, right? Here, if we have a look, this school name is the issuing agency. As the school name is the issuing agency, so it comes in our first line, issuing agency. Second line, we are going to have the word notice. Third line, we are having the date. If you have a look, we are having day, then the month name, no abbreviation, and then year. Next, we are having heading. Heading, we have written in capital letters and we have underlined to highlight it. After that, a space has been left so that our heading is highlighted. Now, all the students, because for whom the question was? Students and visitors. So all the students and visitors of the school are requested not to park. This is the what part of, okay? Requested not to park their vehicles in front of the main gate of the school. So what the notice is about? Requesting the people not to park their vehicles. So this information has been highlighted. This causes inconvenience to the students, the staff, and the foot visitors. So whoever is coming to the school, they are facing inconvenience. So we have additional purpose. Why we are asking them not to park? Because it causes inconvenience. All the vehicles should be parked. So if they shouldn't be parked in the front of school gate, where they should be? They should be parked at the parking lot. And in case someone since getting this information doesn't follow it, doesn't comply, then what do? Defaulters will be penalized. This is going to be the after effect. Okay. So all the important information like this, and defaulters penalized, they have been highlighted. After that, we are concluding our notice by making signatures there. So signatures are there. Who is the writer of this notice? They had mentioned head boy. In our question, there was not the name given. So we had just written one name. So Arush. And what is the designation of Arush? He is a head boy. Okay. So this is the way we write down notice. Important information is always highlighted by underlining it. Now there is another example. Your school is organizing a fete to collect funds for charity. Only school students are eligible to put up stalls. As the head boy or head girl of the school, Meera International, KV Marg, Bengaluru, draft a notice in not more than 50 words to be put up announcing the sale of stalls, giving all other necessary details. Now, if you have a look, the necessary details we have to think of. But what are the value points? First, we talk about format. In format, the very first is issuing agency, that is institution's name. So we have got Meera International. So here we have rough drafted. That what are the points we have to keep in mind. After that, our word notice will come. And then we will write date and heading. So we are keeping in mind what kind of heading it can be there. We can simply write on fate to collect funds for charity. This can be our heading as well. Then the signatory authority. If you have a look, they haven't given us anywhere the name of the head boy or head girl. But definitely their designation has been given. So what we'll do? We'll just remember that name we have to write or designation has been provided. Now, the major content part for which we get 2 marks. What is it? So first, what is the event? The event is a fete. What is the purpose? Why we are having this? So that funds for charity can be collected. Now, when we are talking about charity, in mind, we have to remember that if these funds are collected, to whom these will be donated? So we have to think of one NGO's name also. Third point, where is this event, this complete fete going to be organized? Are we going to hire some venue or are we going to have it in the school ground? We assume that it is in school ground. That's why where and when. On which date and what time? And as the question had mentioned that only school students are eligible to put up stalls. So we have to think that limited stalls and first come first serve basis plus only schools enrolled or bona fide students. And even after this, if they have some other query, then whom they are going to contact, right? This is our rough idea. What kind of information we are going to put up in our notice. So here we have the notice written. Issuing agency, we are having Meera International School. When we are talking about the school name, they have given us Meera International. That was in question. Second line word notice. Third, we are having the date. And fourth line is having the heading. Now formats, opening part complete. We leave a line, spaces there, we left one line. A fate to collect funds for which organization? We mentioned the organization is being organized by the school as per the details. So we are providing the date, time, that is the when part. And where part, we are referring to venue. Stalls being limited in number will be allotted to only bona fide student. It means no other outside student can join. Will be allotted to bona fide students of the school on first come, first serve basis. And in case they have further query, interested students may contact Miss Aarti. If you have a look here, we have given the name and by which date we are writing that. If you have a look, there is one information. Can you think of what is the flaw in this notice? Read it carefully and check out. Is there any error in this? Yes, there is one. After Miss Aarti, we have not provided her designation. So we have to provide her designation also. That is an error. You have to remember that this is must. Once we have provided this, our notice becomes complete. We conclude by putting signatures, Arush and head boy, because this very notice was supposed to be written by a head boy or a head girl. After this, we have few practice questions for you to follow. If you have a look, just three are there, but a different types they are. I hope once you go through these very practice questions, try to write down the answers to them. You will have better command on notice writing. To help you a bit, have a look. The first one, they have given us Rakesh, secretary. It means we have got the writer's name, his designation. And who is he? Secretary to Students Union. So this is complete designation. Issuing agency, Government School, Kanpur. And for what purpose? We are talking about some contributions. So donations we are talking about. Donations for what? For earthquake victims. You have to remember in this question, you will have to provide which earthquake, so the region, and contributions, what kind of contributions can students or teachers make in the school. So we are talking about clothes, we are talking about the dry food items, we are talking about books. You will have to be specific, and where they are going to be collected, even that location you will have to mention in the school. Next question, you are sports captain. Now designation is there, but no name has been provided. So you will have to think of a name. School's name is given, King's Public School. So issuing that one is there. Now they are saying there is going to be an inter-school basketball. Now, inter-school basketball, and you are the sports captain, it means you are gearing up your team. So tell them about the practice sessions, talk about which timings, which days, and if the selection is to be done, comment on that too. And which sports teacher who is to be contacted? Mention that. You are secretary. Again, designation, but no name. And secretary to what? They have mentioned the schools, tours, and travels club. But if you have a look in our complete question, they have not given the name of the school. It means issuing agency, institution's name has not been given. It is just mentioned as your school. So you will have to write down the name of the school on your own. Further, the notice is about tracking holiday. So you will have to mention for which class students, two, which place they are going to track, three, what are going to be the charges, and what that charges are going to include or exclude. Provide all the necessary information and your notices complete. I hope you all would have understood the notice writing in detail and would be able to improve on it. Thank you. Have a nice learning.